Now, let us learn types of plant tissues in this video. Okay. Plant tissues. In my previous video, I have explained you what is a tissue and some experiments, activities on tissues. Understood? And how to observe plant tissues. Everything I have explained you in the previous video. In this video, let us understand types of plant tissues. Okay. So, plant tissues are of four types. Meristematic tissue, next dermal tissue, next one is ground tissue. The fourth one is vascular tissue. Meristematic tissue, dermal tissue, ground tissue, vascular tissue. These are the four types of tissues present in case of plant. Okay. Now, meristematic tissue is a continuously dividing tissue. And these other three types are permanent tissues. So we can also divide plant tissues into two types based on the division. Continuously dividing tissues and permanent tissues. Okay, so continuously dividing tissue is meristematic tissue, and permanent tissue, that means no division will occur in this remaining three. Okay, now meristematic tissue is a continuously dividing tissue. Then meristematic tissue is further divided into three types. Okay, so they are apical meristematic tissue, next lateral meristematic tissue, and third one is intercalary meristematic tissue. Intercalary meristematic tissue is also called as cambium. So this is also called as cambium. Now let us see where apical meristematic, lateral meristematic, intercalary meristematic tissues are present and what is their use. Okay. So, this is a plant. This is a plant. The root, this is the tip of the root. This is the tip of the shoot. So, on the tip of the root and shoot, apical meristematic tissue is present. Okay. Apical means tip. So, you should remember the word apical. Apex means tip. So, it is present on the tip of the root and tip of the shoot. And what is the function of this? They help in the growth. They help in the growth of the root and help in the growth of the shoot. Understood? So this is the root tip. In this root tip, apical meristematic tissue is present, which helps in the growth of the root. Further, then it is also present, apical meristematic tissue is also present on shoot tip, which helps in the growth of the shoot. Got it? Now, lateral meristematic tissue, these are present around the stem, on lateral sides of the stem. What is the use of this lateral meristematic tissue? They help in the growth of the stem. Okay, they help in the overall growth of the stem. Okay. Now, this is a stem part, and the lateral sides at the edges of this stem, lateral sides, this lateral meristematic tissue is present. This helps in the growth around the stem part. Third one is intercalary meristematic tissue or cambium. Where these are present? These are present between the leaf base. This is leaf base. So leaf base and the stem, in between this is present. Okay, so where a flower arises, where a bud arises, or where a leaf arises, leaf base also they are present. Okay, and they are also present in between the stem part and the leaf base part. These are present in intercalary places, they are present. So they help in branching. Okay, where new branches arises, they help in the growth of new branches. Got it? So this is about intercalary meristem. So remember that meristematic tissues are continuously dividing and there are no intercellular spaces between the cells. So these are small cells with thin cell wall. Got it? Cells, they have prominent nucleus. They have prominent nucleus and with a dense cytoplasm. Cytoplasm is very dense, more cytoplasm content is present in the cell, and these are continuously dividing cells. These are continuously dividing cells. Understood? And here, no intercellular spaces means no gaps between two cells. Generally, if cells are present like this, then gap will be there. Okay, between these two cells. Okay, gap. So here, no gaps are present. So no intercellular space. Intercellular means between the cells. So between the cells, there is no gap or no space. Okay, so this is about meristematic tissue. Okay, so meristematic tissues are continuously dividing cells. These are small cells with a thin cell wall. They have prominent nucleus with dense cytoplasm. They don't have intercellular spaces. And these are of three types: apical meristematic tissue, lateral meristematic tissue, intercalary meristematic tissue is also called as cambium. Apical meristematic tissue is present on root tip or shoot tip. They help in the growth of shoot and root. Lateral meristematic tissues, they are present on the stem edges, lateral sides. Understood? They help in the growth of the stem, around the stem. Next, intercalary meristematic tissue, these are present in leaf base or flower or branches, where branches arises, and they're also present in between the leaf base and stem. Understood? Where bird or flower or fruit arises. Got it? So this is about meristematic tissue. Now let us